consider our current ordinance. The current ordinance talks about fee schedules from zones to non-zone. In a nutshell, it's divided the city in zones, and then they charge a certain rate based off zones. Once these cab companies, or at least one of them approached us, Mr. Hanson gave us directions that we contact them, to meet with them. There's actually five companies, cab companies currently licensed in the city. So myself and my staff met with them. What we found out was is that four of the five are already using what we call taxi meters. And that's just simply the devices. It's put up, it's displayed, and it shows the calculation rate. They're currently actually operating in contrary to what the ordinance says right now, which is zone scale. While frankly, looking at two other city ordinances, from other cities that use taxi meter, this actually appears to be more fair. It lets the passenger know exactly what they're expected to pay. So the big change, and we did meet with the cab companies and go over some of these proposed changes. And I've got summarized here. Teresa attached to your packet, and the draft highlighted the change we made. The big ones, to be exact, is that when we talked about this, was the requirement
assuming that the one that either was charging a lot more or wasn't doing what they were doing has, is falling in line and going to do this.
Correct, yes, sir. We, all five companies, we all, and they all agree that was the right thing to do, so it's an accident.
And then my second question is, the only thing that, I don't disagree with this and I will vote for it, but the thing that bothers me a little is the amounts of money in an ordinance that I'm not sure that they should set and they should, and does that make sense? I'm kind of a little leery of us said of us coming to 35 cents when maybe they want $1.50 per mile or that, and so if they, all five of them, want more money, do they have to come to us to get us to change our ordinance? Do you see where I'm coming from? I really need somebody to explain to me why we are setting a fee for a private business.
Let me give you an example, Randy, where I think I can explain. It's the same thing with our tow services. In our ordinance and in our process, we set a maximum charge they can charge at. We have, in fact, found, and we dealt with those companies, they're charging ridiculous amounts. To me, this is a cap. This is the max you can charge. I understand the concern. We're governing what a private business might want to charge. But again, here's what you're doing on my counter-argument. We're prohibiting them from taking advantage of the public. I know you're good with that. But the other part is that they agree to this. Now, do we need their consensus? No, of course we don't. You are the governing body, you get to decide it. But they're on board with it. They agree it's fair. And I personally, and not a caveat, I'm not defending them, but quite frankly, when I sat down with them, they were concerned about overcharging customers. We walked out of there, I was kind of scratching my head and said, geez, I expected an argument. And in fact, some of them were concerned about overcharging. Is it competition? Of course. You know, that may have been behind the scenes too, though. But, you know, I think they agree with it. I think we're protecting our citizens. We do the same thing with tow services. There's been plenty of times where I've had a citizen, we towed their car because the police arrested somebody and towed their vehicle. They come and say, hey, that record driver charged me X number of dollars. And I'm not saying they do a lot, because they don't, because I'm not slamming their car, tow drivers. But sometimes, if they overcharge it, it's a mechanism to protect the public.
Sure. And so I'm assuming we didn't just pull 35 cents a mile out of a hat, that is maybe a standard.
That is it. We looked at other ordinances. Okay. Right. And that's kind of what we're dealing with.
Any city of our size would have an ordinance in that local government would establish the rates. And anywhere you can go to Washington, D.C., you land at the airport. And that's the problem with it. It's just based on your consumer, you land. It's not like there are nine companies out there and you go and open the door of each one and say, what's your rate? So if somebody can charge what they want, you're on the last flight, it gets in here and it's late at 1 a.m. and there's one cab, and the guy says, here, I'll take you, but it's $50. I mean, that's not a good reputation for your community. So I think it's common that the local government establishes rates.
Look, I like this process. We talk, sit down, talk with them. We would all be good for them. Everybody walked up shaking their hands. Here's what I would say. If later on they feel like we're not being charged enough, you're the governing body, you need to decide. They need to come to us and say, look, can you present this to council and make a change? We're certainly welcome to do that. That's, to me, the way the process works. I agree with you. I don't like to. Unfortunately, we have to do that.
Okay, any other questions?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Jack?
Yeah, I share some of the same concerns that Rob in terms of a business and regulating how much they can charge. And my question, I guess my concern, can we leave it with that? You know, we can move the cab. Why can't we move the gas company? Because the cab is public transportation. A cab is, I don't know if I would consider it public. That's something you make a decision about if you want to get in a cab or not.
You do. But he's out there to serve the public. Okay, and Larry's illustration is perfectly good. If you picked up 1 o'clock at the airport and it's the only cab there and he wants $50 to take you to the first hotel, it's kind of ridiculous.
process. I sign on those taxi cab permits myself, but they go through licensing, and they get all that in front of them at that time. And I think that the practice of getting a license, and we give them a copy of the cart ordinance anyway. And I'll tell you how it's helped us, because when they, for to say another business, and I won't pick on a particular business, but say a business company says, well, they know that. Well, you were given a copy of the ordinance. You were obligated to read it. But I'll answer this way. You're the governing body. If they come back, and I think that meeting was very beneficial you asked us to have, because they come back later and say, look, we really need to charge more because this is not fair, we can't operate business. You better let us know that. That's something we'll, then we'll come back to you all and say, maybe we need to reconsider that. What I like about this is, yes, I agree with you. We're telling them what they can charge. I think we're protecting citizens, but we can't on it. But the other part is, we created a mechanism where they can come and talk to us and we go like, you all are going to be body. Or they're afraid to come to a, you know, citizens to be heard. But the meeting was productive. I think we're on board. I think it's a way. I don't think it's right if you're going to use the argument that I'll just land at the airport. And it's not right to charge someone $100 to go. They jump in. the other ones is we look at other cities, and in fact, the rest we talked about. So we put that in there to be fair.
That doesn't say anything about it. The guy, if he put that luggage in there and you were happy with his service when you got through, that you couldn't tip him.
Oh, you did.
I'm going to get one of them to say, you see, they call for care.
Uh-huh.
And they come. It takes me about 15 minutes to get from my house. I mean, I'm waiting, I'm there waiting 15 minutes. Do the price of the pay them start after I get in care.
Okay, well, let's use your example. Say you call care. And they pulled up there. One of the complaints is they're about 15 minutes in time and somebody shows up and gets in the car. Well, they can't charge that time. Then they're stuck because it's, you know, the zone cop schedule right now. Well, after 5 minutes, say after 5 minutes, they will start their meeting.